Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my channel. Today I'll be showing you how to install Xampp Server in your Windows 10 operating system. So let's begin. Now to install Xampp Server, first we need to download it. So for that I'll be just opening my browser and I will type Xampp download for Windows and I will click on enter. And now see, the first search result is from this apachefriends.org. So we are basically going to click on that, this download Xampp Apache Friends. Yeah. Now in here, as you can see, there's basically four versions available to download. Four versions of PHP that we are going to run on our Xampp server. So 7.2.34, 7.3.25, 7.4.13, and our latest version, that is this PHP 8 version. Now I am going to download this PHP 8 version because I am going to write all my code in PHP 8 only, because this is the latest version. Now if you want to write your code in PHP 7, that's alright, because PHP 8 has just recently came, so you can still take some time before moving on to PHP 8. So for that, if you wish, if you can also download PHP 7 versions Xampp. So depending upon you, you just click on that download button. I'm going to download PHP 8. So for that, I am just clicking on this download 64-bit option. It's 156 MB file, so it will take some minute or two to download. I have already downloaded this file, so I'll just going to cancel this and I'm going to open my download sections. And in here, as you can see, this is my Xampp Windows 64-bit 8 versions has been already downloaded. So I'm going to just double click on that. And now, as you can see, this Bitnami is a company. And here basically your setup wizard has been opened. So now just simply click on next. Yeah, and these are the basically the options that this installation is going to be done. I'll just keep this all default and just simply click on next. And now this is basically the installation directory, that is this C drive Xampp. I'm just going to keep this default, so just simply click on next. If you want to change your destination, then you can always change your destination by clicking on that browse icon and you can change your destination. I will recommend not to change this destination unless you have some stronger reason to change that. Otherwise just simply keep it default and simply click on next. Yeah. Now here this is basically two languages given, one is English, another is Dutch, I think. I'll just keep this English only and simply click on next. And now as you can see, a pop-up came through my browser, that is this Xampp server, saying us hello to your favorite application on Xampp. There are other several components available through Xampp, and the most popular one is WordPress. I'll be showing you how to install WordPress in your Xampp server, and you can use the entire WordPress completely free. I'll show that in my next video. So for that, just subscribe our channel and press the bell icon so that you can receive that notification. So, and there are basically some other components also that this Xampp server also supports. Joomla, Drupal, all are popular, but the most popular thing is WordPress. I'll show that. Now just simply minimize it, and as you can see, the setup wizard has been opened saying that it's ready to install. So just simply click on next. Yeah, and the installation has been began. It will take a minute or two, so I'll just simply speed this up and I will come back once when it's done. Now before completion of installation, you might see this type of pop-up came from Windows Firewall telling that Windows Firewall has blocked some features on this app. So basically this is a server that you are going to use. So what you need to do is you need to just click on that private network, such as my home or work network, check, Yeah. And just click on allow access. Yeah. And now, as you can see, the installation has been finished. So just click on finish. And the Xampp control panel has been opened now. So I'll just start this Apache server and my MySQL database. As you can see, another pop-up came from this Windows firewall, telling that the Windows firewall has blocked some features on this app. So for that, I'll just need to click on this private network, such as my home or work network, checked, so that it allow my MySQL to communicate on this network. It's very necessary. So for that, just simply click on simply check on that box and just click on allow access. Yeah. Now just simply click on admin, yeah, to open your PHP MyAdmin. Now this is your basically MySQL. So what I'll be doing is I'll be writing a small PHP snippet, and I will just run it, and I'll show you how to run PHP snippet using your Xampp server. PHP is a server-side programming language which only runs on server. So that's why we need to install this Xampp server. So I'll just simply go to your C directory and then click on Xampp. Yeah. And now in here, just click on htdocs. Yeah. This is the folder where you are going to place all your project files, all PHP files and everything on this folder. This is very important, because if you don't paste your project files and all other PHP files in this directory, your projects is not going to run. This is very important. So just simply remember this htdoc folder. This is very, very important. Now we are going to write a PHP code snippet. So for that, I'll just search notepad, and I'll just click on it, and I'll write some PHP code snippet. So PHP, yeah, echo hello world. Now just save this program in your htdoc folder. This is very important, as I mentioned already. Now in here, just save as my first PHP program .php, and just save as type to all files. This is also very important, because you are going to save this file as a .php extension. So now just simply click on save. Yeah. Now that your my first PHP program .php has been saved, so just copy the file name. Yeah. And now just go to your browser, and in here write localhost, yeah, / now just simply paste your file name and just click on enter. Now there you go, the hello world. That is what we need to print, right? So I'll just change this hello world to hello everyone, and just save it. Now I'll just simply refresh it, and there you go, hello everyone has been rightly shown on your browser. So that is how you run your PHP files in Xampp server. So as I mentioned, for that it is very important to save your file in your htdoc folder. So that's all for this video, friends. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up, and also please share with your friends, and also don't forget to subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. As I said earlier, that I am going to post a new video that how to install WordPress on your Xampp server and how to use WordPress for free. So that's my next video coming up. So once again, thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.